Hi, my name is Kadi and I'm currently a senior software engineer at Formidable. The main goal of this course is to give you, the JavaScript or React web developer, an easy intro into the world of React Native. We will especially be focusing on the things that are different and similar between the web and the mobile platforms. In this course, we will look at what is React Native, what problem is it solving, and how does Expo fit into the mix. We will then cover all the basics you need to know to get started building your very own app from the ground up. We will cover styling, the special React Native components for rendering lists, building forms, and fetching data using network requests with React hooks. I hope you enjoy the course. Now what we want to do is actually wire all of this up. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to go to app.js and remove all the code that we copied away to color palette. So we don't need the styles. Don't need this. Don't need the colors. And don't need any of this. So we just have the navigation container. Next up, let's import both the home and the color palette screens. Now we want to import the create stack navigator from React Navigation /stack. And we want to create our stack. And this basically creates like kind of like a sandbox of screens that you can navigate between in a stack. And then we're going to use it inside a navigation container. So we have a stack dot, what's it called? Navigator. Right, so this is actually defining the stack navigator. And then we're defining all the screens in a stack. So we do stack dot screen. And we give it a name and a component. So name, home, component. And let's add another one for the color palette. Cool, so now we got a home and a color palette, and we'd like to navigate between them. So what I want to do is I want this to stay serialized, and if I press on this, I want that new page to appear. So let's go to home, and in order to add interactivity into applications, we need some way to register user tabs. Now on the web, you would have a button that has an on click, but on a phone, we don't click, we press. So we have a selection of touchable components. I've got a list of them here. There's touchable opacity, touchable highlight, touchable route feedback, and touchable native feedback. Most of the time you'll be using touchable opacity and touchable without feedback. Basically, touchable opacity will create some opacity while the press is ongoing in the component that it's wrapped around. And touchable without feedback has no visual feedback, but it will register the tab. So let's go ahead and use the touchable opacity. The way that the touchable elements work is that you basically wrap them around the area that you want to make touchable. So let's import this. And let's just wrap it around the text. Now on the web, you would have an on click, and on native, you have an on press. And on press takes a function of something you want to do when the user presses on this. Now, how do we navigate between screens? Well, I think you should definitely get used to looking at the documentation, because I do a lot. So if we just React Navigation docs, there's a light mode as well, if it's more to your liking. And so I basically used a navigation prop. So any screen that is inside this stack navigator that's defined here. So any screen that you pass into as a component also gets this special prop passed in called navigation. And navigation has a bunch of things that it lets you do. You can navigate between screens, you can reset the navigator states, you can go back, you can set params, etc. So we're going to use it to navigate to a different screen. So home, and this gets passed into here, so navigation. And all you can do is here in the onPress, we can do navigation.navigate. And then we just pass in the name of the screen we want to navigate to. I'm going to rename this to Solarized. Yeah, we got the basics. So one of the things to notice is that in React Navigation, the default color for the background is actually not white. It's kind of this grayish color. So I usually end up making the color white. So if I do container background color white. And we also don't need the safe area view anymore, because as you can see, because we have this header bar already, React Navigation kind of handles the safe area for us, which is kind of handy. So we're going to reduce this because we don't need that much of it. Cool. So the thing to note is we use the actual name of the screen to navigate to it. So the screen names need to be unique. So if we look at app.js, we're actually using this home or color palette. So if we rename this name, we'll have to also rename all the places where we use it to navigate. And because there's lots and lots and lots of things, we're going to use a flat list. Now we're going to go, let's go underneath palette name and do flat list. So here our data is the colors. Our key extractor will be item, color name. Then render item, going to get the item, which is the individual color. And now we can pretty much just copy this, the switch code that we made earlier, and put it in here. So here the color name will now be item color name. And for the styles, we don't need to change anything. Cool. Now we've got an array of all the colors. So next, what we want to do, we can actually remove some of this padding now, some of this margin now. Okay, so the next thing you want to do is, obviously these are all turned on by default. We want some way to actually track what's turned on and what's off. So in order to do this, let's create a new state variable to hold this. So let's create one for selected colors only. So let's do selected colors and set selected colors use state, and let's start with an empty array. Now we want this selected colors array basically to contain, like each contain one of these. So here, where we decide where something is selected, we do, so this value is either true or false based on whether it's selected or not. So all we can do is we can do if selected colors bind, so this is color, which is an individual item. So color, color name is the same as this item color name. And it's true. And basically what we want here is we want to force this into being a Boolean. And a handy way to do that is a double exclamation mark. So a single exclamation mark would make this the opposite of what it was before. So if it was true, it would be false. If it was an object, it would be false. And then a double one will just basically convert it into a Boolean and then convert it back. So you make it truthy. Cool. So now all of these are not selected, which is correct because like we don't have any items in our array. And what last thing we need to wire up is this onValue change. So let's create another callback. Let's call it handleValueChange. And here we get two things. So we get the value, so whether the user turned this thing on or off. So value, and also we get the whole color. Nice. So here basically if value is true, so this means that the user has toggled the button on. We want to add the color into our selected colors array. So let's do set selected colors. And we do care what the current ones are. So we do colors. And we return all the colors, but with the current one added. And in this case, we don't really, do we care? I guess I'm adding the it's to the end of the color list, but I guess it doesn't matter too much. And then otherwise, if the value is false, we know that the user has toggled it to be off. And in this case, we are going to remove it from our current color array. So we do set selected colors. And then we're just going to filter the color that they deselected out. Actually, I can't call this color. I'm going to call it selected color. And I'm going to do selected color name. All right, so here it basically does colors.filter, and this filters out everything where the color name is the selected color name. So in theory, so the reason it doesn't work is that we aren't actually calling this this function. So we need to add it to onValueChange. So onValueChange will return selected. So this is the Boolean. And in this case, we do actually want to call this explicitly because we want to pass in two things. We want to pass in selected and also the color that we're currently working on. So these two arguments. There you go. So, I think this might have to be a converse. Okay, yeah. So I had a small mistake here when I did a filter. I filtered everything out rather than this. So if you followed along, make sure this is a negation. And now I can select all of these. Let's actually add some interesting colors here. Oh, why did these not show up? I know why, because I've hard-coded this colors array to be empty. So let's do selected colors here. So I'm just gonna refresh. Yay, that's pretty cool.